Good morning, Nicholas. I have put together something here and I wanted to show it to you to see if you think this might be a way that I can actually, shape the cube into a sphere. I've got this structure here, which is just a bunch of 2x4s. And on the bottom, you'll see I have a wheelchair gearhead motor, which I use, my kids make electric cars and race them around campus. So I happen to have a couple of motors around. Show you a little more details here. We've got a wheel here, which is hooked up to the motor on the bottom side there. And if I turn on the power supply over here, that sends electricity to the motor. And if we're lucky, now you can see here we have the motor shaft is turning pretty quickly, but it's a worm drive gear, so it goes pretty slowly. We can make this thing if we turn up the voltage on this guy. You can make it go quite a bit faster. If you're doing something where you're braiding it off and you want it to just go real quick. But it also can be lowered down really quite slow. I mean, just a volt or two. And then it's moving so slowly that I was thinking about maybe using heat to cut a hot wire. So I have this other power supply here, which can be turned on. And when it's turned on, we can raise some volts, and you notice we have quite a few amps to go through this guy. What that's hooked up to is a little magic wand that I have here. Let's see if we can see that. Yeah, okay, we have this guy, which basically is just a large wire, large gauge. It'll handle 10, 15 amps, and it gets all the way up to red hot, which is not the styrofoam. Now, when the cube arrives, being able to help me for just $45 get this thing going, I will put it on the wheel, and then up top here, I have a second wheel, which you'll see can come down, and this is just basically an idle gear, or idle bearing, and so what that will do is it will just hold the top of the cube still. It's pretty low friction. It'll hold the top of the cube still, but not still. It'll rotate, but it'll hold it in one position. So we'll have a cube which is being spun by the force of this motor and is being held in the exact right position for this motor. And the 2x4s will just be a frame that holds the whole thing together. So if I am lucky and it turns out that I can actually get so this thing just goes around like that. And of course, it'll be larger and it'll be flopper like that. As well. Then what we might be able to do is turn this thing on. And if I raise the voltage up enough, I get 8 amps. Now it's 12 amps. And rising. And it goes slowly, it'll pop straight. But this thing will actually get all the way to a red hot. I see it now, starting to glow a little bit there maybe. I have a larger power supply so I can get it definitely red hot. But this thing actually, it's a pretty thick wire, so it has a large thermal mass. And what it's able to do is just cut off styrofoam like nothing. So what I'm thinking about doing is actually rotate this guy, and then I can position this at certain angles, and as it's going around, it'll make progressive slices off of this thing and get down to our approximate sphere, and then I can use a sanding machine or whatever. So my question to you is, will this work? I'm excited. I don't know if it even has a chance, but I decided I'd go to the expert before I actually put a block on here and then end up wasting all my time. But anyways, it does really just, I mean, it's like it's so easy to cut through. It just falls apart like that. So that's my proposal, and I look forward to see what you think about this being a dumb idea or sheer brilliance or something in between. So I'll be talking to you later today, or maybe you have already called me or whatever. Anyways, hope you enjoy the video. Bye-bye.